Well, good afternoon, good morning, or good evening, depending on where you're joining us from. My name is Meredith Wood, and I'm a program manager here at Antwerp Management School. And I'm joined by my colleague as well.
Yes, hi, I'm Annex Cronin from the Antwerp Management School. I'm the academic director for the creative industries, and I'm also a professor at the University of Antwerp, a master program in cultural management. And since 6 years, we are also organizing a summer school in fashion management. And so we thought now the time has come that we have to launch this brand new international master in fashion management. And so we will explain to you now what you can expect from this new program.
Mm-hmm. So, of course, we're both happy to be here with you all today and to share some information. Like she said, about one of our newest and our most exciting master programs. So to get started. Before we get started, let us walk you through what we'll be doing today. Of course, I'll start with a little bit about Antwerp Management School in general. And then the academic director will talk about the International Master in Fashion Management more in depth. And I'll finish up with some information on the leadership and the career development track, something that we think sets us apart from other schools, and of course, how to apply, because we think you'll be convinced to apply. And we'll finish up with a question and answer session. So save your questions, because we will get around to them. So to start, it's really important to note that our school is internationally recognized. It's these accreditations that really give our degree value. So we are accredited by the AACSB, which is an American and a global accreditation, along with the NVAO, which is a Dutch-Flemish accreditation. Something else that we're very proud of is that our master's in management are ranked number one in Belgium and number 30 worldwide. So of course, that's a stat that we're really proud to share with you all. And at AMS, we like to consider ourselves the world within a school. It would be a pity to study an international master, you know, not being in an international environment, but we've definitely got that covered. Just this year, we've got 33 nationalities in our school alone. And in Antwerp, there are over 170 different nationalities, making it, I think, the second most diverse city in all of Europe. So we definitely have the international environment here. Before going into further detail about our International Master in Fashion Management, it's a nice opportunity to shed some light on our other programs here at AMS. At AMS, we offer 7 English-speaking and 2 Dutch-speaking full-time master programs. You can see them all on your screen now, but if any of them interest you, of course, we encourage you to get into touch with us, because we're happy to share more information about some other ones in the future. But now I will pass it off.
Yes, hi. As you know probably, Antwerp is known for its high-end independent designers. And so therefore we thought that Antwerp is really a good place to organize an international master in fashion management. And when you compare other programs, existing programs, they are more focusing on luxury. And we really want to start from this entrepreneurial approach from the high-end independent designers. But that doesn't mean that we are also open for other kinds of jobs in the fashion industry, because we want to offer you a very broad program that is really tailor-made so that it meets your expectations. So let's go through the program. So it's an international master in fashion management. That means that we do not stay in Antwerp, we will go to other places as well. But first, what are the aims of our program? First of all, we want to prepare you to a job in the fashion industry. It's the fast-growing industry in the world, in the fast-growing creative industry in the world, and it's a huge, huge business. So we want to prepare you for mid and senior management functions, because we are offering a program at a master's level. So there is a lot of diversity within the industry, from the high end to the retail, to the more street labels and the independent designer. So we want to cover them all. What is the core of the program? We want to learn you what it means to be local, but also to operate global. So the local and global dimension. And also, what are the dynamics of the existing markets, the mature markets? And we will also want to look at the emerging markets, because that's the future. And so then you will be really prepared to enter the fashion industry. And therefore, we will look at first at your personality, who are you, what do you want, what are your expectations? And then we want to offer you a program that is organized in three parts. First in Antwerp, where you will have the foundations of management, going from strategic management to marketing, to HR, of course, and also financial management. But always immediately applicable to the fashion industry, because we believe that the fashion industry has certain dynamics, and that is really worth it to look at these specific dynamics. Otherwise, you could follow another more generic management program. But no, we really believe in these specificities of the fashion management, the fashion industry. So after the foundations in Antwerp, with the basic management skills, and also looking at the challenges in the industry, certain topics like sustainability, you can't deny that, it's so present in the fashion industry, sustainability, but also entrepreneurship, the impact of digitization, it's huge, and that's also the reason why I like, as an academic director, the fashion industry, because all the new tendencies, and trends in society are very present in the fashion industry. So how to deal with that and how to integrate that also in your own business, for example. So when you have these foundations in Antwerp, then you go to Milan. And in Milan, you will apply immediately the knowledge, the foundations that you get in Antwerp into a consultancy project and for an Italian company. And it will be an international collaboration. So their students and you will be in separated in groups, and you have to prepare this consultancy project. And at the end of six weeks, you have to present your conclusions, your analysis, of course, and your conclusions and recommendations to the company. And then you're going 4 weeks to Sao Paulo. So that's an emerging market. And very important is to look at the context. What is the specificities of the fashion market in Brazil? And you have also their global labels, but also an emerging independent designers. But what are you going to do there? First, you get two courses about the context and the fashion industry in Brazil. But before you left Antwerp, you had to define a project. You choose a company, a fashion company, and a topic that is relevant for this fashion company. And you it has to have an international dimension. It's because the company knows that you're going to Brazil. So you're going to collect your data in Brazil. And we will coach you in that, we will guide you. There will be an international supervisory team that will coach you, so don't be afraid of that. And so after these 4 weeks, you come back to Antwerp, and there you can really focus on this personal project. And this personal project has two parts. One part is the presentation of your research, and again, the conclusions and recommendations that you want to do to the fashion company you choose. And on the other hand, you have a kind of portfolio, because you went around the world. You went to Milan, to Sao Paulo, and also to London. That's also included in the program. And you made a kind of report of your journey. So what did you learn from these different locations? And you can use all kind of means. Your photograph like pictures, for example, but also other media. And you make a kind of presentation, and we will Each student will present their journey in a kind of marketplace for a whole day. And with the panel, with the jury, we will look at your journey, at your portfolio. So two parts for your final master project. So that's in a nutshell what is the concept of the program. And yeah, I know, I don't know, we don't see you, unfortunately. We don't know what your background is, but you see there in the presentation what are the requirements and what kind of people we want to attract. But maybe during the questionnaire, you can ask some more questions about that. So to summarize, what is the USP of the program? It's a real international collaboration with three locations that are our partners. It is also a unique program because we want to focus on the local and the global and on existing markets and emerging markets. And we focus also on the new challenges for the fashion industry. And finally, what is important, that's your master project, because that's really key. It's really a red thread through the program. So it's really integrated. And in this way, we want to meet your expectations and what are your needs, and that you will graduate with, that you are prepared to enter the fashion industry. So there you have again in the presentation, the summary of what I said, with the different topics and the different management skills. Then you see what is included in the curriculum. So at the left side, you see the program from September to December in Antwerp. I can assure you that we also select the best teachers. The program will be a mix of academic knowledge, but also of cases. So professionals that will explain how they work in their company. And the past year, the previous years, we developed really good relations with the fashion industry also in Antwerp. Yeah? So going from Ralph Simons to Dries van Noten, Anne de Meulemeester, I van der Vorst, so one really the high-end independent designers, but also the street labels. Maybe you know Essentiel or other Belgian labels. And then we have the retailers, so also cases about H&M or GBC in Belgium, Zara, that's a very known case, of course. But cases are also important. And then what we offer also is the network. So it's really also a ticket to enter the industry, because you will get to know a lot of people. And I can show you that's really important in this industry, that you know the right people to enter the industry. Then the second trimester, so you go to Milano and to Sao Paulo, and then finally you come back to Antwerp, and you will have this personal coaching on your project and the career development portfolio. But that will explain Meredith.
So
what I said, so it is you get theory, but it's practice oriented. So you apply immediately the knowledge you get to the practice, and that makes that you learn much faster, because by applying it, you remind it much better, and you know also what the theory means in its relevance to the practice. That's the company that will come, and then the personal project. Okay. And then the last, that's a presentation of our partners. And so in Milan, you have several schools, but Domus Academy. We have a very good relation with them. And this consultancy project is really well designed. And so I went there past year, and I could also see and control the quality that they offer. So, and they are also international. So it will give you an international network. And then the third partner is FAB. They offer different kinds of programs, from business administration to fine arts. And as you can see on the picture, The location is also lovely. It's really, you have this colored glass in the hall, they have a museum, they have also a theater. And so you will be in a context of art and culture, really inspiring environment. And then the London Culture Fashion, I didn't tell you a lot about that, but when you are in Antwerp from September to December, we will also go to London for a weekend. And it's really our trip to London. In the beginning, we wanted to have that also as one of our big partners, but they were not ready yet. So that will be maybe for the future, but you will be in contact with our colleagues of London. And of course, the London Culture Fashion is that's really the entrance to the world. They are among the top five arts universities in the world. Yeah, about the practical project, the master project, I told you already something, maybe for the questioner, if you have more questions about that, we can answer that later on. As I said, it's tailor-made. You have also this additional portfolio, and it's linked to a company and to your own interest. So we have to find a topic that meets, that is really your interest area, but that's also relevant for the company, of course. We will be a go-between, of course, we will help you in that. You can also choose a company for your country, so it doesn't have to be a company from Belgium. So if you are from Eastern Europe or Africa or Asia, you can also choose a company from your country. So we are very open to that. Yeah, so this practical project is key. And there you can show what you learned through the year. So the knowledge that you get will be really integrated into your project. And what are, very important for you, of course, what are your job opportunities afterwards? If you want to develop an own label that is international, nowadays you have to be international. It's not an option to be to stay very, very local if you want to be profitable. And so how to internationalize also your own label? Or you say, no, I really choose for the existing companies, you can apply for the existing companies for different functions, from HR to marketing to financial department, always at a mid or senior level. So because it's a master level program. And that can be from the global fashion labels to the local ones. And then if you want to start also an own company in consultancy, also possible, because there are a lot of needs in the sector. And I think the creative part was always very important. Of course, it is the most important. But I think it's only since a few years that the attention for the management part is increasing and is growing. So we want to feel this need to make the creative person stronger. So, and this collaboration between the artistic part, creative part, and otherwise the business part, that's really the challenge. Therefore, we are not like other companies. No, it's really the combination of creativity and business. And finally, if you want to go into academia, you are very welcome, because also the research in fashion and fashion management is growing. It's really interesting to see. Fashion is becoming, and fashion management, a real topic for research as well. Then the practical details. Meredith, are you going to tell that, or I can finish?
Sure, finish.
Today, okay. So the tuition fee is 19,000. And what is included? That's the program, of course, and the quality of the program, the teachers, and also the trip to London, and the expenses at the locations. For the course material, we charge extra 500. Less than 500.
Yeah, around 500 for your books.
Yes. And so it's for the whole year. What is not included, because that will probably be your first question, is the travel cost and your stay, the accommodation at the different locations. But we help you. And Milan works together with an agency that really offers not expensive location, and you can go there in group or not, that's your own choice. Why we didn't include that in the fee, because nowadays youngsters are so creative to find cheap ways to stay or to travel, that it's better that you can develop or look for it at your own. But again, we are there to advise you, to help you, and to find the best places at an affordable price. So, I think that's it.
Yep, so one thing at AMS that we think really sets us apart from other people is our leadership and career development track, because we really focus on you as an individual. We want to help develop your weaknesses into strengths and your strengths even further. We think that these soft skills are equally as important as the hard skills that you'll learn in the classroom. So we do put a really big emphasis on our LCBT program. This actually starts right away in the beginning of the academic year with a couple onboarding days. You'll see on your screen, this is when you do sessions such as presentation skills, design thinking, and sustainability. In the beginning of the year, we also go as a class to the Netherlands, where pretty much you stay in a big house and you learn about who you are individually, as well as who you are in a group setting. So it's kind of like an icebreaker as well to get to know the rest of the people studying in your international fashion management program as well. And then throughout the entire year, there is a lot of different workshops that you can participate in, such as negotiation skills, conflict management, how to lead, stress management, and more. But of course, it could not be the leadership and the career development track without the career aspect. Of course, our goal here is all the same, for you to get a quality education and to find the best possible job for yourself. So we do our best to help you there, as you mentioned a little bit earlier. Through our career development track, we have CV and cover letter writing workshops. Each year, we have a couple different company fairs. So we've got multinational to local companies that come in to the school just to talk to our students and hopefully to recruit some of you all. Throughout the entire year, we also have a lot of different networking events, including alumni networking events, speed dating with different companies, and a lot of different networking drinks where you can meet business people. We like to think we give you all the tools to find a successful career, and now you just have to use them and put them into action to find a job that is best for you. And of course, what is done outside of the classroom is also really important, because it wouldn't be a fun year if it was just stuck inside the classroom the entire time. So we also offer a lot of extracurricular activities. Each year at AMS, there is a student council that puts on activities that they choose. So normally there's the things such as the international dinner, which is the very first event that they put on, which is the bottom row that you can see with all the different flags on screen. So that's when you bring food and the dishes that are, you know, local to your own culture or to your own home, and you share them with the rest of the people. Because as we mentioned earlier, it's a really international setting here. They also last year had a Halloween party, a LinkedIn photo shoot. So there's also a lot of fun happening outside of the classroom too. You have the chance to participate in the Google Digital Master Academy and to become AdWords certified. So if you wanted to go into marketing, then this would be the perfect opportunity for you as well. Something invaluable to put on your resume. And each year we offer an international trip to Dublin, which is really a tech hub to visit some innovative companies such as Salesforce, HubSpot, Google. This year we also went to Dropbox too. So you have to apply for that one, but it's another great opportunity to mingle with people from different programs. If you don't believe anything that we're saying, you can of course check out what our students have to say too. Each year they also keep a student blog, which you can see the link for on the screen, so definitely check that out. And because we're all millennials at heart, we have a hashtag AMSLife. On your screen already, you can see some of our photos that we have on that hashtag, but you can also see photos that our current students are posting from all over the world, wherever they are right now. And because I'm sure we've done a good job at convincing you on why this is the right program for you, so now how to apply. We have a three-step application process. First, you have to complete our online application form, which is uploading your motivation essay, which you can find those instructions online. Also uploading your CV, your transcript, and if you're from a non-native English-speaking country, also a TOEFL or an IELTS. Then you'd be invited to take an online numerical or verbal assessment. And after successfully completing that, you'd be invited either for an in-person, if you're local, or Skype interview with a program manager. It is important to note that the deadline for you all to apply is June 1st, but of course, the earlier the better. So if you're interested, definitely start that application. And if you have any other questions that we don't answer now, please feel free to contact Laura, whose information is found on screen. But now we can go ahead and welcome any questions that you all might have.
Okay, would you like some help with the questions? There are some questions that have appeared already during the presentation.
Yeah, I just saw, let me see, it's popping up. Which part of the application process is most important for you? It's your profile as a whole is what's really important. Of course, as long as you're qualified to apply for the program, that's the first step. But also the motivation. We want people that want to be here and want to study and that are open-minded as well. So that's what I would think. Agree? Let's see this one. Okay. Sure.
Yeah. Yes. In which companies are your students work after graduation? So we have already experience in that. It depends of your interest, but we have already several students who are now working with Ralph Simons. So Ralph Simons is of course working for Calvin Klein, but he has also his own label, and they were with a team of five, and they have now, three of our students are now working there after their graduation. And so I said it already, we really developed good contacts with the fashion industry, with the high-end designers in Belgium, but also abroad. Yeah, we have good contacts. I know some of our students who went to Paul Smith, other ones to also not only in the clothing industry, but also to Estée Lauder, or in perfume, or so. It's really what we offer is really this network, and it depends of your own interest, and we can help you to connect with the right people. And so I'm quite confident about that we can bring you in contact with the right people, and that we offer this broad range of opportunities.
Okay, there's also a few questions about scholarships. So at AMS, we have a few partially funded scholarships of 5,000 euros. Those are applicable to people that, of course, applied, have gotten in, and have already paid their first installment. Again, it's a partial scholarship, so it does not cover the entirety of the tuition fee, but it is 5,000 euros, so that is some of it. Let's see. Do you want to maybe answer that one?
Yes. Why did you create anything with Paris schools? Do you plan that in the future? Thank you. To be honest, we have already a collaboration with Institut Français de la Mode in Paris. It's a very good collaboration, but that's for our summer school. And for the master program, we decided to work with Italy and with London and Sao Paulo, because also, yeah, in a partnership, it's always important that, that not only the ambitions are the same, but also the rhythm. And so therefore you have to look at the timing, if they are, they want to develop a master program, an international master program or not. And so we have already this collaboration, but if it's really important for you, what we can do is to look in the future that our trip that we organize in the first semester can be 1 year to London, the other year in Paris. That's possible because I said we have already a collaboration with IFM in Paris. Because of the language, of course, we also collaborate with London, with Brazil, but that was not the main reason. It was more what is the time for the school in Paris and our timing and who could we match that. That was the main reason.
Okay. Someone else asked if, you know, they're from Singapore, so will you be able to get a job in Europe or in America after this, because it might be tough not having close connections with the companies, and because of visa issues. So it's possible, of course. Every year at AMS in general, we have some of our international students that do stay in Belgium or in Europe. It's possible. It's not as easy for you as an international as it might be for a Belgian, of course, to get a job in Belgium, but that does not mean it's impossible. But we also say start early, start, you know, already in the first semester, networking and getting to know some contacts. And of course, through the program, you'll be put into contact with a bunch of different companies. So it's about the impression that you make too, that really makes a difference if they want to go through the visa process for you.
Yeah, and I'm not convinced what you say. Yeah. It's more difficult for an international one than for someone from Belgium to get a job, because the fashion industry is so international.
Okay.
So it's really, it depends on the competences and of the way how you approach them. So so maybe when you compare it to local companies, and in the fashion industry it's difficult. They have this international scope. But anyway,
then I like that answer better. Someone asked about the program fees, the tuition. That was 19,000 euros. Correct. Is it possible to do an internship or a part-time job during the study? Normally, we recommend, and of course, correct me if I'm wrong, not to work because it's a full-time program. So a lot of their time is already spent.
Yeah, indeed. So, but of course, there will be a close collaboration in Italy with the company. And with the company you choose for your master projects. But real time to spend that for an internship, the program is so full that it's not possible. But of course, to make your analysis for your master's project, you need to be in close contact. And there will be an agreement, of course, because what you are researching is also relevant for the company, and they will be open to see how you can collaborate. Yeah? So we can look at the internship maybe afterwards, but give us some time to look how we do that. It's a full program, so you need all your time. I can assure you.
Someone else asked, are the expenses, so does the tuition cover living in Belgium? That does not, so housing is also on your own. But if you are admitted, you do get an international student handbook that gives you a lot of different links and tips on how to find housing in Antwerp. Someone asked, is the program based in New York? No, this one is in Antwerp, Belgium, based in Antwerp. But as you mentioned, it does do some significant traveling as well.
Yeah. Of course, when you when we designed the program, you can collaborate with the whole world because there are a lot of interesting places. We have connections with Hong Kong, with Taiwan, with India, with New York. It is, mm-hmm. has a collaboration with New York, and it was one of the scenarios. But you need to consider and to make choices. And why we didn't choose for the start for New York, because that the program would be even more expensive. So we also wanted to balance that. Yeah, but it doesn't exclude in also in the future that New York can there can be a collaboration, but at this moment it is not. Yes. The Louis Vuitton is one of the cases, of course, and we have connections with people who are working in the company. One of them is a lady, and she's the head of the marketing department. And she's of course a very interesting woman to invite for a case analysis. So we have connections, indeed. So that's an answer to your question.
Someone asked about our rankings with the Financial Times. So for our master's in management, we are number one in Belgium and number 30 in the world. So those are the Financial Times rankings. Those are all of the questions that I see on the screen. If anyone has any last minute questions, please feel free to send those in as well. The fees are the same for both EU and non-EU students.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And the deadline is the same as well. So.
So we went through the list of questions, but maybe you still have there are some questions left, or we have another question, or we didn't answer. You are not totally satisfied by our answer, then it's opportunity now to raise another.
So what are usually the backgrounds of the applicants? This one just came in.
I know. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Do you want to answer?
I am, but I'm using the background. The backgrounds of the applicants for the management school in general, you can say that better, but for fashion management and for our summer school, it is really very interesting because it's really a mix, it is very diverse public. Audience coming from abroad, but also from local, and also a mix of people who are already working in industry and a master's. So it's not only learning from teachers and from cases, but also from each other. And I think these different backgrounds is really an asset, an advantage of the program, because the program is focusing on these different contexts. It's important for the fashion industry to take that into account. Not all the labels are global. And even then, you need to take into account the context. And so bringing all these different backgrounds together also in the group of students, gives a very interesting mix. Not only that, also the educational background can be different. So you can come from a management education program, but also from a creative program. And also that is really, for me, as an academic director, I think that's one of the advantages of the program. It's really an asset to have this mix of backgrounds. And it's also a challenge, because you don't start from the same level of knowledge. And so it's up to us to see that everybody learns a lot, and also can reach the same level of education. So it's a challenge for the teachers, but for the group, it's really very interesting and very pleasant to have this mix.
Mm-hmm. I think those are all of the questions again that we see. I see one that says, are procedures to fashion management, but I'm not totally sure what you mean there. So if you could clarify, then we could probably answer it.
Okay, I would like to thank our wonderful presenters for the interesting presentation. You really answered in detail so many questions. I'm sure all the attendees have additional questions, and maybe after the presentation they will think about it and they can write back to us or directly to you. You see on the screen your website and also the emails, and you get back to them with your answers.